made some changes from our last upwind sail. We're gonna try this out again today on another upwind sail. We have cloud coverage right now. Thank God. We're roasting. I will trade anyone for snow for a week. You can come out to the blistering hot islands and I will make snow angels. Oh my gosh. You ready? Okay. Anchors up.
Whenever you're starting up and getting ready to get underway, it's a good idea to check to make sure that your steering system works and that your propulsion system works before you untie from the dock or weigh anchor, because that's the wrong time to find out you can't control your boat.
Stop procrastinating, let's go.
Okay, anchors up, again. I want to show you the wind line so you can really see it. Right out there, not too far, all those white caps. And then presumably the show will begin. Went from 10 knots to just over 19 knots like that. That was kind of a shit show. I'm glad we weren't filming. But at 26 knots, I'm gonna take the jib down. Try to furl. Cannot figure out that furler. We have to do something with that furler on that small jib when it's so powered up. It kept slipping and I would get the jib almost furled and then it would unfurl. And then almost to the point that my arms were just, I couldn't do it anymore. So Ryan called to drop the sail and of course it's wild. And I did. And that's what I get for it. Figure it out. And I debriefed afterwards, and it's not so much strength, it's technique and working more together with getting this sail in. She's a great sail upwind. I'm looking forward to getting back out there and trying it again so I have a little bit more confidence. Test number three. Experiment. Number two, three, something. Well, we only have about maybe 12 or 13 knots of wind, but we wanted to see if our next experiment with this little jib worked. It came out perfectly, but we could do it from the cockpit. Whoa, I feel like a drunk sailor here. This is the setup that we have. What Ryan did a little bit differently is this sheet right here was like pressed really hard against the Dyneema, and the Dyneema was higher. So what Ryan did was is he took more Dyneema and he tied it off and he brought it down just a little bit. So now the sheet barely touches it. I can lift it with my pinky. So we just have to keep a watch on that if there would be any chafe at all, but Dyneema is pretty slippery. He also was able to drop this down a little bit more, and now the furler line is lead, because we had an extra hole right here. Yay, so now we get to use it. And we go all the way to the cockpit. So again, the real test is gonna be in a couple days when we go upwind, and there's a forecast for some strong winds again, because we're the upwind boat. And we'll see if this works, but if it does, my body will love me. I am healing, getting better. Today is the day we hope we have enough wind, a lot of wind, for going upwind. I can't believe I'm saying that. So that we can test out our new system. It worked in light winds, it worked at anchor. Now we have to see if it will work in stronger winds. Let's go find out.
Okay.
I'm ready when you are.
Let's see what happens. Nicole.
Yes.
Very bad wrap forward. Let's see if I can get it out.
So why did that happen?
Because you let that be totally flat. Or you didn't keep tension on it.
Got it.
Can you see it?
Yeah, I can see it. One slight little problem unfurling, but that was on my end. And I didn't have to go forward, nor Ryan, to fix it. He was able to do it from here, which is what we're trying to figure out, if we can do most of it here in the cockpit. Not having to go forward and get doused and totally wet when unfurling the smaller jib. Now I'm just hoping that it works when we furl the jib, that I can still stay in the cockpit. Staying in the cockpit didn't last too long. The sail needed a bit more luff tension, and the only way to do that was to go forward and tighten the jib halyard. Going 1-point-something knots to almost 8 knots in about 30 seconds. Not bad. 0 to 8 in 30 seconds. The Ferrari on the seas. Time to furl. Let's see if this works. All right. Moment of truth. And I've just been informed that I'm doing it all by myself.
And you're running out of time.
Oh, okay.
Going forward?
Yeah. That seemed to work, but the wind died down to 17 knots. We were looking for maybe trying this in 30 knots. But at least so far, the experiment worked. I'm happy. I didn't have to go forward and battle that furl in the sail. It worked in the cockpit a little bit slower, but soon it is time to drop the main. I'm out of breath. That's kind of sad. Off to the Tuamotus and beyond, and a lot of the places that we're going to be going, if they have internet, it is 2G. So we will be filming a lot, but we will probably not be uploading as much. I'm hoping that we can at least one episode a month, maybe two if we're lucky, but don't forget about us. Thank you for subscribing, and thank you for always liking. And remember, click that little bell as a reminder of when we have a new episode up. We hope to come back with some great stuff. You're being what? Productive. We're getting ready.